In 1865, James Clerk Maxwell introduced wave theory of light. According to this, light is an electromagnetic wave whose energy depends on the intensity of that wave. The more waves incident on a surface per second, the higher the intensity and energy of the light. A few years later, Philip Lennard discovered the ionization of gas from ultraviolet light and observed that gas absorbs the incident light and emits electron, whose energy depends on the frequency of light, not on the intensity. Lennard's observation was exact opposite of Maxwell's wave theory of light, which made it a puzzle that energy of light depends on intensity or frequency. Albert Einstein explained this puzzle through a phenomena of light called photoelectric effect. Einstein took the help of Max Planck's radiation law to explain the photoelectric effect. To explain blackbody radiation, Max Planck suggested that light is not a continuous wave as Maxwell had said. Rather, light consists of particles. Einstein named this quantum of light photon. Each photon is a packet of fixed energy which depends on the frequency of the light. The energy of a radiation is equal to the multiple of the frequency of radiation and a very small tiny number, which is called quantum of light, and this small number is called Planck constant. To get it proved, he incident light on a metal surface. In metal, electrons are free to move, but they do not have enough energy to eject from metal surface themselves. Because the height of the potential well on the surface is more than the electron's energy, so a fixed amount of energy is required to bring the electron to the metal surface, which is called the electron's work function or binding energy. When light incident on the metal surface, photons interact with these electrons. During this interaction, electrons follow all or nothing principle. If energy of the photon is equal or greater than the work function of electron, then the electron absorbs that energy. But if energy of the photon is less than the work function of electron, then it does not absorb that energy at all. If energy of photon is exactly equal to the work function, then the electrons absorb that energy and only come out to the metal surface. But if the energy of photon is more than the work function, then electron spends some part of entire energy reaching to the surface and the rest of the remaining energy is converted into kinetic energy. With this kinetic energy, electron move freely. This is called the photoelectric effect. The photoelectric effect requires that photon have a minimum required amount of energy. Low energy photons are not able to eject from the metal surface. The corresponding frequency of this minimum energy is called threshold frequency. If the frequency of photon is less than this threshold value, then electrons will not be able to eject from the surface. If the frequency is equal to this threshold value, then they will eject from the surface, but they will not have enough energy left to move forward. But if the frequency of photon is more than threshold value, then electrons will not only eject from the surface, but also move with the kinetic energy. This kinetic energy of electron depends on the frequency of photon. The higher the frequency of photon than threshold value, with the more energy electron will eject. So, Maxwell's wave theory about light is wrong? Well, it is not so. There are some phenomena of light in nature that can be explained only by Maxwell's wave theory, while other phenomena from Max Planck and Einstein's quantum of light. In this way, light is a wave as well as a particle. This is called wave-particle duality. De Broglie extended this concept saying that not only light but every quantity of the universe has both particle and wave nature. This dual nature of any quantity is the base of quantum physics.